I'll make a motion that we include Article 14.3.4 of the mediation, that paragraph that would need to be introduced. One second. This is once we get into discussion.
Smiley, yes. Mrs. O'Hara, yes. Mr. Oshia?
Yes.
Mr. Swansky?
Yes.
Mr. Vannen?
Yes. 15.8.5, in case of liability. Gilbane was gonna offer the following exception to this provision. This one goes at the end, except to the extent paid by the proceeds of available insurance. That's the amount you can make through here.
What number you want?
15.8.5, on page 39. That was one that they agreed to.
Chairman, that Bob, you don't have that, right?
Yes.
Huh? We don't have a copy of that, right? You have a copy of there, we don't have a copy of it, right? Am I wrong?
Did you receive it in an email?
We have a letter, looks like a letter taken on.
Oh, okay.
It's only.
It was printed out for you, the vehicle officer.
Do we have this here? Okay, I was just trying to verify if you follow along.
Can we just make a, make a motion to add that line?
Yeah. 15.8.5, it's supposed to say, except to the extent paid by the proceeds of available insurance.
Mr. Chairman, I think the confusion is that there was Gilbane's response to Mr. Reilly's comments, but then there was the one, the memo.
Then we got the memorandum.
Memo.
We got the memorandum.
Of their agreement, which was supposed to be in the contract. So all we're doing right now, thus far, is just voting to put in the agreement what Gilbane has agreed to put in the agreement. They just didn't do it, they just didn't do it. They just didn't do it, I don't know why, but we didn't. So once you do that, this is just not even a.
I think with red, you have that, I know you do, everybody has that. But then we had the issue met, all the bodies met, and they came up with this. This is, and then they issued it, but.
The contract that was last, should have these in it. Just got the contract, what was it, Friday?
Friday, the 22nd, with the changes.
Right, it was supposed to include all these changes, and we found out this morning that it did not. I think the president is just trying to make sure that your consideration includes all the changes, I don't want to speak for the president.
So on 15.8.5, add the word, except to the extent paid by the proceeds of available insurance. Motion for that?
So moved.
Motion by Mrs. Vannen, is there a second, by Mrs. O'Hara? Any other discussion? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Smiley, yes. Mrs. O'Hara, yes. Mr. Oshia?
Yes.
Mr. Swansky?
Yes.
Mr. Vannen?
Yes.
How
just want everybody to have on both sides. This is the front end of a document that is going to get bigger. This is the first piece of the design build agreement. When they actually come up and they get bids, they come in with the GMB, and you actually identify the design builder. That's Exhibit A for this contract. And Exhibit B we already have, which is the insurance and bonding of Gilbane and their people. We have that piece. This piece, it's important to get this piece correct, because there were subsequent pieces that follow and they go into. That was the issue that I had. I had issues with the contract. I have no issues with the superintendent, what he's done. No issues with what Mr. Seabee's done. They're doing outstanding work. I have no issues with that Gilbane can handle this project. Those are not concerns of mine. The concerns were the language in this contract, protecting the town. Those are my concerns.
I guess you should just make the council aware of the discussion regarding consequence damage and limitation of liability to the amount of fees. That discussion was had, and that's not in this contract. It was brought up at the meeting between yourself, myself, the chairman, Mr. Seabee. The contract. That's a council decision whether you want to pay additional costs to have those exposure to the rain. I think that was an issue that was kind of left on the table. My understanding, I don't think a decision was made. That's my understanding.
Are you saying that was one of the issues that Attorney Reale got?
Right. Mr. Reale raised two issues that to the council was that there's an exclusion for consequential damages to trust go to Sawa, and the limitation of liability to Gilbane will only be to the amount of their fees, which I don't know is about
$475.
That's their fee, and their local might be, they could be interpreted as $76,000. And so that's the extent of their exposure in this case. And the issue came up, why should we limit their exposure $4 million contract to the amount of their fees? And the response that we received was it'll cost them, it'll end up costing us more money because they're going to...
The fee would change.
So if you wanted that kind of protection, it cost us more money.
And that was one of those things that...
That was just...
Joe Reale said, we can leave it that way. If you're okay with it, we can leave it that way. They've got a dog in the game, so it's something. If we wanted more, we'd pay more. So it's one of those things. The reality of it actually coming true is in my mind. It's not even a fly-by-night company. I have experience working with Gilbane. We're sitting in it. We had no issues. We expect the same thing.
I think in our conversations with the superintendent, Mr. Seabee, the biggest risk is that the project isn't completed on time for occupants. And what happens then? And I believe, it's my understanding that we don't think that's likely. And what you saw earlier is that, call it simple. I mean, a 5,000 square foot building is not inconsequential, but it takes time. But it really isn't a complicated structure. If you're building at the right time of the year, it should move along quickly. But should it not, for whatever reason, if it starts raining from April 1st to August 30th, my understanding is we can accommodate students without the four classrooms by making some accommodations, if you will.
And when we talked about that, that was in my mind, I was thinking temporarily. We were like a week or two off.
Right.
You know, that, yeah, yes, we could temporarily make some accommodation. I'm concerned about if there's a long-term stoppage to the current progress that we have. I don't want to put our teachers and our students into that level of absorption if it's to go out, you know, months or however long.
Is there anything that if, for example, it wasn't completed on time and it was to, say, go past a couple of weeks, is there anything to protect that it would contribute to cover the cost of a hardship on us?
That's what being, that's what's not included.
That's what's not included.
What is indicated, though, is if we include that, we're going to pay a higher fee for that. So,
what is the fee?
If I may.
Well, if you have, I think, Council and I have the same question.
I'm not aware of the fee, so I'm just curious. What is the future fee?
The fee that Gilbane is going to charge on this thing, is a percentage. It's actually different from the cost proposal that prior council approved on July 16th, 2018, it was 1.9%. This contract is 2.9% because Gilbane now is not going to be the construction manager. They're actually going to be the design builder. They're going through the process of being the design builder. They're actually going to be the construction of the project, which will determine that the town will now need to go out and hire project management services. Which they're in the process of doing right now. They're in the process of doing that bid spec for the project manager.
So to be in your office on Tuesday.
So there's a letter. They have a letter from Gilbane stating that that's why the cost increases there. But everything is on percentages. Most of the stuff is on percentages, and you'll see that in the next piece of the contract, the design build contract. You'll state the price. It'll tell you what the contingencies and what the contingencies are on both sides, what the fee structure is all behind.
Well, not with anything, it's because of that weather, we know early in the game how are we not proposing our plan. So we have that fallback.
Well, I think they have to make a commitment because their budget is showing that reduction based on how we propose. We're at that point that once we turn the corner, we're committed to that. And I don't have a problem. This building will be built. It will be open. It will be open for 15 more months. Substantially completed.
That's the intent. On our current schedule.
Weather should be.
David's got a review for
substantial compliance, not as long. So,
to avoid scheduling another meeting with.
Right. If I'm following this correctly, James is going to check it for form, make sure it's as it should be. Some of their eyes, Gary's going to have the authority to make the changes, or to offer the changes.
Thank you. Can I speak for myself? Nobody's more committed to this than me. Thank you. Trust me. Trust me on the whole project.
We need
a motion to ratify the contract after council solicitors review the form and those changes in the agreement and authorize it to be administered and signed.
I make a motion that we ratify the form after our solicitor has reviewed the contract and the form.
The form will be substantially consistent with what
we do today.
Those changes that we agreed to.
Those are already.
Second.
Any other discussion?
Yes. Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Ogier?
Yes.
Mr. Walensky?
Yes.
Mrs.
I was hoping no one would ask Claire to repeat that.
Oh, no. I get up as poor as my dispatcher.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it. It's on our agenda as well, discussion, but we've already voted this through, so I don't think that we have anything to talk about.
Just know that we're here to help. If anything, you know, we had a discussion from last week with yourself and the defendant and Aaron that you need to move to the panel. Just let us know when we're here.
Thank you.
Because there are obviously there are things that need to go through the panel and make sure that it continues to move forward.
We'll, in the future, we'll actually bring you in much earlier rather than, you know, at this time. So we can save the legal fees and you guys pay.
What he does for a living, though.
Yeah.
We have a deal with him. So.
Thank you.
Believe me, he's worked out really well for the town in the last 10 years.
Second, all in favor? Aye. All opposed? Guys, aye.